Christ is risen. Christ has truly risen indeed. Alleluia. Welcome to Hilldale on this third Sunday of Easter. And a special welcome to those who have joined us online and to the Past Lake community as well, who are part of our service. Though we aren't physically present, we are joined together in the risen Christ. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are raised with him to new life. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in this beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and your word created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. And at the river your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By water and your word, you claim us as daughters and sons, making us heirs of your crop, of your promise, and servants of all. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life. And above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Christ. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Let us join in singing our gathering hymn. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always, and also with you. Let us pray. O God, your Son makes himself known to his disciples in the breaking of bread. Open the eyes of our faith, that we may see him in his redeeming work, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. If there are any children viewing, this is your time. It's so good to see you, and we miss having you in our church. I'm going to say some words and they might surprise you. Alleluia, Christ is risen. These words are the traditional Easter words that we say. Did you know that it's still Easter in our church? Easter is a season of 50 days. It begins on Easter Sunday and ends on Pentecost. Usually Easter is a real happy time. We have lots of flowers in our worship space. There's none here right now. We sing hymns. We celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. And often family and friends gather together to share a meal together. But sadly, this Easter was different due to the coronavirus. Churches were empty. There was no beautiful music playing in our churches. We couldn't even visit our friends and our family, your grandparents, cousins. We all had to stay home. And we did that for a reason. We did that so that we could be safe and everyone else could remain healthy. I have to say, it's a rather scary time. It's a scary time for all of us. We don't know when this is going to end. We don't know when we can come back together in our church, or we don't know when we can go back to school or play with our friends. But here's the thing I want you to remember. No matter how upside down our world is today, God is with us during this crazy time. Did you know that God's hand is right on your shoulder, even if you can't feel it? God cares about you. And no matter how upside down everything is, God cares about you, God is with you. We can talk to God, we can pray. We can pray to God when we're scared, even when we're happy, or when we're confused. God never leaves us. On that first Easter Sunday, the disciples were so sad. They were disappointed, they were confused. They didn't know what was going on. Their friend Jesus had died. And that's sad when someone dies. But guess what? They had a surprise. And I think you know what happened. God did not cancel Easter. Jesus rose from the dead, and we celebrate Easter, even though our churches are closed. Those disciples, like us, they didn't know what tomorrow was going to be like, but they knew that Jesus promised to be with them all the time. Let us pray. Risen Lord, we thank you that you are with us all the time. When we're scared, anxious, remind us of how much you love us. Keep us all safe and healthy. Above all, we thank you that Easter has not been canceled. Christ is risen. Amen. I'd like you now to hear a song for your reflection and meditation. And it is played for us by Mona and Bill Wiltshire, who are part of the Pass Lake Church community.
To walk with me all alone. happy. Lord, walk with me. When I'm happy, Lord, walk with me. All along my pilgrim's journey, you walk, Jesus, you walk with me.
Hear now our first reading and our song, read to us by Heikki Luoma.
This reading is from the second chapter of Acts, verses 14a and 36 to 41. Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed the crowd. Therefore, let the entire house of Israel know with certainty that God has made him both Lord and Messiah, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the other apostles, "Brothers, what should we do?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, so that your sins may be forgiven, and that you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is for you, for your children, and for all who are far away, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to him." And he testified with many other arguments and exhorted them, saying, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." So those who welcomed his message were baptized, and that day about 3,000 persons were added. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. This reading is from Psalm 116, verses 1 through 4 and 12 through 19. I love the Lord because he has heard my voice and my supplications. Because he inclined his ear to me, therefore I will call on him as long as I live. The snares of death encompassed me, the pangs of Sheol laid hold on me. I suffered distress and anguish. Then I called on the name of the Lord. O Lord, I pray, save my life. What shall I return to the Lord for all his bounty to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the child of your serving girl. You have loosed my bonds. I will offer to you a thanksgiving sacrifice and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, Lord. To whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. The Holy Gospel, according to the 24th chapter of the Gospel according to Luke. Very early in the morning, on the first day of the week, the women went to the tomb, bringing the fragrant spices they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they went in, they didn't find the body of the Lord Jesus. They didn't know what to make of this. Suddenly, two men were standing beside them in gleaming, bright clothing. The women were frightened and bowed their faces towards the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for him among the living? He is not here. He has been raised." On that same day, two disciples were traveling to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were talking to each other about everything that had happened. While they were discussing these things, Jesus himself arrived and joined them on their journey. They were prevented from recognizing him. He said to them, "What are you talking about as you walk along?" They stopped, their faces downcast. The one named Cleopas replied, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who is unaware of the things that have taken place there over the last few days?" He said to them, "What things?" They said to him, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth. Because of his powerful words and deeds, He was recognized by God and all the people as a prophet. But our chief priests and our leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. We had hoped he was the one who would redeem Israel. All these things happened 3 days ago. But there's more. Some women from our group have left us stunned. They went to the tomb early this morning and didn't find his body. They came to us saying that they had even seen a vision of an angel who told them he is alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had said. They didn't see him. Then Jesus said to them, "You foolish people, your dull minds keep you from believing all that the prophets talked about. Wasn't it necessary for the Christ to suffer these things and then enter into his glory?" Then he interpreted for them the things written about himself in all the scriptures, starting with Moses and going through the prophets. When they came to Emmaus, he acted as if he were going on ahead. But they urged him, saying, "Stay with us. It's nearly evening, and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. After he took a seat at the table with them, he took the bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "Their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. But he disappeared from their sight. They said to each other, "Weren't our hearts on fire when he spoke to us along the road and when he explained the scriptures for us?" They got up right then and returned to Jerusalem. They found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying to each other, "The Lord has really risen. He appeared to Simon." Then the two disciples described what had happened along the road and how Jesus was made known to them as he broke the bread. The Gospel of the Lord. Dear friends in Christ, grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Canadians were stunned and heartbroken this past weekend to hear of the senseless violence that unfolded in Nova Scotia. A lone gunman claimed the lives of 22 people in several small communities. It's hard for us to wrap our heads around how this could happen. Why on earth would someone do this? And at the same time, we are battling another battle, COVID-19. We are all trying our best to keep ourselves and everyone else safe and lower our risk of contracting this horrible virus. One of the cruelest aspects of COVID-19 pandemic is its power to deny people the opportunity to say their final goodbyes publicly to their loved ones. Community is one of the things that makes life worth living. One of the things that help us come into the fullness of who we are. I miss gathering together Sunday mornings. And I have to say that Easter Sunday was almost depressing this year, knowing that churches would not be filled, the doors would be locked, choirs and music would be silent this year. Dinners with family and friends and church family would be canceled. I also miss those times with my swim gym friends and the coffee times we share following our workouts. I miss gathering with my other friends. I miss visiting with my colleagues, chatting. I miss not talking to my neighbors. And I miss not being able to socialize with my friends. But above all, I miss giving hugs to my family and my friends. It's such a lonely time for many folks. Some days I feel like I'm riding a roller coaster. Our experience of community has been altered. Yes, community still exists, but we don't have that opportunity to gather together in homes and public places. Sadly, there will be no public gatherings for family and friends of those who lost their lives in this horrible shooting, or for those who have lost loved ones during this pandemic. This all feels unnatural. Although we know that our current isolation is saving lives, we long to hug those who grieve. Our gospel story for today feels like a cruel joke during pandemic Easter. This powerful story weaves together table fellowship, wonder, irony, misunderstanding, hospitality, faithfulness. Today in our text, Luke transports us back to Easter evening, that same day when Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary, and the other women discover the empty tomb, and Peter confirms their news. And then later that day, we meet two of Jesus' disciples who are traveling on the road from Jerusalem to a village called Emmaus. The two, one named Cleopas, we are told, are discussing all that's happened, how Jesus had taught and healed, how that same Jesus was betrayed, flogged, and made a spectacle of shame, and how that same Jesus had breathed his last and was laid in a sealed tomb. And to top it all off, there was a report that Jesus' body was missing. Now, how could that possibly be? There was a big stone rolled over the tomb. Was this fake news? So these two disciples got out of Dodge as quickly as possible. They knew their very lives could be in danger. Can't you just picture Cleopas and the other disciple walking down that road of disappointment and pain, with their heads down, trying to make sense of all that they had seen and heard? I've been down that road, that same road, and I'm sure you have walked that road too. On their 7-mile jaunt back to Emmaus, their words and hearts are heavy. Like the people of Nova Scotia, their world has dramatically changed in just one weekend. Life would never be the same. The two disciples' conversation is filled with questions and pain, bewilderment, and a strong sense of loss. We had hoped he was the one to redeem Israel. How many times have we said those words, "We had hoped"? We had hoped that the tumor wasn't malignant. We had hoped the depression would lift. We had hoped to keep our jobs. We had hoped the pandemic would spare our family. We had hoped a mass shooting would never happen in Nova Scotia or elsewhere. We say these words, "we had hoped," when we come to the end of our ropes, when our hopes are dashed, when our cherished dreams are snuffed out. I think this text tells us something about God. You see, Jesus meets these two travelers right where they are on that road, right smack in the middle of all of their pain, their frustration, their confusion, and their sorrow. Jesus is a good listener, you know. He is neither testing, nor scolding, nor humiliating them. There he is, present with them as he listens to their story. Once they tell their story, Jesus tells their story back to them. And as he does so, the story changes. In Jesus' retelling, their story becomes what it really was, something far richer, wiser, and deeper than what the travelers had understood. Jesus grounds his story in memory, tradition, in history, and in scripture. While Jesus tells the story, his listeners' hearts burn. Once the travelers reach Emmaus, Jesus gives them the option to continue on without him. Do they want him to stay? Are they willing to risk having a stranger in their home? Cleopas and his companions say yes. Yes, please stay with us, it's evening. And these are the words of a patient Jesus. He waits to hear a word of welcome. He doesn't barge in. Once they are all seated around the table, Jesus takes bread, blesses, breaks, and gives. Such a simple thing that can change everything. A bit of bread, a sip of wine, a common table, a shared meal. God seems to have a way of showing up in our rituals and patterns of everyday lives. God appears in the text messages you send to someone who is lonely. God is present in the phone calls you make to call a person who is undergoing treatment or waiting for results. God is with you on your daily walk while trying to isolate and maintain a bit of sanity. God appears in your Zoom meetings, our online worship. The sacred is present in our technology as we stumble to make sense of it. And here is the good news, dear friends. The risen Christ is not confined in any way by the seemingly smallness of our lives. Wherever, whenever we make room for Jesus, Jesus comes. So many things are different than we hope for, and yet the Savior still meets us on our lonely road to Emmaus. The guest who becomes our host still meets us on the lonely road to Emmaus. The guest still nourishes us with presence, word, and bread. So look for him, listen for him, keep on walking, keep telling the story, and may your hearts burn. Christ is risen. Alleluia. Amen. Our hymn today, it's a new hymn. It has a familiar tune, I'm sure you'll recognize it, but it was written to be sung during the pandemic Easter 2020, while churches remain closed and people are self-isolating in their homes. I hope you find the words meaningful, as did I.
Thank you.
uplifted by the promise of healing and resurrection. We join the people of God in all times and places, praying for the church, the world, and all those in need. For those whose hearts are fervent with love for your gospel, that they are empowered to tell the story of your love in their lives and show hospitality in response to this love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our diverse world, for jungles, prairies, forests, valleys, mountains, endangered animals, who all call these spaces home, that they are nourished, nurtured, and protected. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all who call upon your healing name, give rest. Stay with all who are hungry, friendless, despairing, and desire healing in body and spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the community of Port-au-Prince, for those who have died, for those who are injured, for families of loved ones, and all who mourn. We pray also for Gabriel Workman's family. Lord, in your mercy. For those who have lost loved ones and are unable to have or attend public gatherings to celebrate the life of their loved one, may God hold them all in strong, loving arms. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all those who are frontline workers during this pandemic, for doctors, nurses, researchers, support workers, X-ray technicians, administrators, epidemiologists, law enforcement, grocers, farmers, truckers, delivery drivers, emergency workers. And we pray for the sick, for the grieving, for those whom we name in our hearts. For my friend Marie, who has lost her husband. For Pastor Tager, whose wife passed away last Easter Eve. And those whom we name in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Receive now God's blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Let us now join in singing our closing hymn. Thank you. The church has been deployed to the world. Go in peace. Share the peace of Christ, the good news. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.